G'day guys, I'm out here today searching for Kahikatea seed to make a video of how to grow Kahikatea. And fortunately it's mid-March, perfect time, and there's no shortage where I am. But firstly, I'm just going to show you Kahikatea trees around. So pretty much where I'm standing, all around we have Kahikatea. See the conical shape there? So they're not super old trees. They've got that cone shape there when they're sort of mid-growing. This guy's a massive one, this one. Some more, maybe some totaras and bits and pieces here. Here's some more Kahikatea here, bloody tall them. Another guy here. And this one here is going to be our specimen. You can't see it on this video, I don't think, from here. But we'll go have a look at his chocolate with fruit. Let's go. Okay, so I've come up to this tree here. And I'll show you guys the fruits and the seeds, so we'll have a look. So here we go. A lot of seed on this tree, every branch. So if we take a closer look, the orange guys are the fruit, they're the ripe fruit, that's the ones we want. And the black capsule on the end is a seed. So idea is, bird eats that whole lot. Goes, does its business, seed passes through, and the Kahikatea spreads that way. We are not birds, however, so we don't actually need to eat the seed, which is good. But I'll show you now how to collect it and get it ready to sow when we get home. So our collection method here is pretty straightforward. We're just going to pick the whole fruit and seed, take them home. We can discard the fruit later. We don't need that, but for now, we're just going to grab the whole lot. Just pick them. Here we go. Into my container. So I'm just going to keep going through and picking these out. I grew some last year and germination rate was really good. So hopefully we can expect that again. Good, so I'll take quite a few, because if we're going to do some, we may as well do plenty. And there's definitely no shortage here. There'll be enough left for our bird mates to spread around. So here's the result of that picking. It's a container of seed. I'm guessing there's probably about 100 odd in there, which is going to give me enough for about one seed tray worth, which is perfect. Yep, as you can see, it's the whole fruit with the seed still attached. So I'll process that when I get home, and then I'll show you guys that and how to sow it. Let's
go. Pretty cool here. This kiru has just landed in this Kahikatea and is having a big feast on berries.
Back at base camp now, ready to prep these seeds to sow. This bit is pretty easy. Next step, just want to separate the seed from the fruit, so literally just going to pull it apart, just like so. Obviously we want to keep the seed, we don't need the fruit anymore, so leave that on the tray. And these seeds I'm just going to pop into my container. So I'm going to go through and keep doing this. We could probably leave the seed on the fruit, but I feel like we may as well separate them. If it was going through the bird dispersal system, then that would be the end result, just the seed by itself. So we want to mimic nature if we can. The fruit is actually quite nice to eat. It's quite sweet, slight piney taste. All separated now. Here's my seed. There was 150, so my estimate was a little bit off. It's in a hundy, but that's a good amount. That's still going to fit in one seed tray, so that'll work. So that's why I'm keeping my seed. And this is what I don't need, which is the fruit. So I'll ditch those and continue with the seed. So I've got everything now ready for sowing. Got my standard seed tray, my seed obviously. This is just standard potting mix, which is going to be about the base 2/3 in the seed tray. And this here is a seed raising mix, a bit of a finer mix, and that'll be the top 1/3 or so. So next step, just fill my seed tray with 2/3 full with the potting mix to start with. Okay, so potting mix is in. Now for the seed raising mix. As you can see, it's a bit of a finer blend than your standard potting mix, so that's just going to work better with our seed. Just give it a nicer bed to sit on. Won't get lost in the big chunky potting mix. Next step is to actually sow our seed into our tray. Probably just going to broadcast these in, just basically scatter them. 150 seeds, so I don't really want to be just putting one everyone in individually, but we do it like this. Just try and space them out. Obviously, you don't want big clumps all in one spot. Right, now I just need to cover this with a thin layer of potting mix. Probably only as thick as the actual seeds themselves. So it's not a huge coverage. Just need to be slightly buried. I think that's pretty good. Give it a light tap down. So I'll give it a quick water with my squeezy bottle. Gives a gentle stream, not too strong. The hose can be quite strong. We don't want to give it too much water to disturb the potting mix too much. But we do want to give it a good soak. Get water soaking in without disturbing our mix too much. So that seed should stay in place, nicely spread out. I'll spread it there so that when those seedlings grow, they're not all clumping together. Okay, and last step now, and I didn't have it in the shop before, but it's to cover it over. And I've got this bit of perspex here. It's just clear perspex from Bunnings, which I've cut to size. It's got a bit of water on it, but yeah, it's just gonna sit on the top of our seed tray. Just gonna get rid of any debris on there. So yeah, that's just gonna sit on top like so. And that just makes our life easier because it helps retain moisture. That potting mix isn't going to evaporate as quick, so it's going to stay moist and going to provide a really good environment for our seeds to eventually germinate, which is probably going to be in the spring. So we've got a little bit of waiting to do, as it's only March now, so probably 6 months at least before we can see some progress here. But that's cool, it's just going to do its thing. So I'll pop that in a nice sheltered spot for the rest of the autumn and winter, and then we'll come back in the spring and hopefully we'll see a whole heap of tiny kahikatea coming through.
Hey team, well, welcome back. You probably feel like you've just seen me, which is true because you just have, but in real life it's been about 8 months, so it's here in early December. I planted these guys back mid-March, so they have been in the tray for quite a while now. Pleased to report excellent germination. So we've got our little guys popping up here. Rough count is about 115, so out of 150 seeds, pretty happy with that. So these guys started germinating back in October, so took about, 6 months or so, and just when the weather started to warm up, they started popping up, at which point I took my perspex off, because obviously there's not much clearance in here. So once the seedlings start coming out of the soil, just take your perspex off, make sure you're watering them every day or so depending on how warm it is, and then obviously they've got the space and the oxygen to grow there. Here's a close-up view of our baby kahikatea. So some of them you can still see the seed on top, example that guy there. Most of them have dropped off. There's a couple there still with their seed on. Yeah, so they look almost ferny when they're little like this, and then as they get mature they're foliage changes into what you see on a fully grown tree. So once these guys get a bit bigger, you're going to want to transfer them out into individual pots, which is called pricking out. There's quite a bit of space in this tray, so I'm going to probably let these guys double in size, and then I'll prick them out into individual containers this size. So this is one from last year, so these guys are pretty much about a year and a half old, so they've grown really well.
roots not quite popping out yet, so they'll stay in these containers for a while longer, and then they'll be potted on into bigger bags, let grow a bit bigger. So that's all there really is to it, team. Wasn't too labour intensive, these guys, just a bit of a waiting game over the winter, make sure they're moist, and eventually they're going to make an appearance. And Kahikatea is known as New Zealand's tallest tree species, so who knows, in 500 years we might be looking at 60 metre monster, and I'm not going to be around to see it, but that's okay. Cheers for watching and happy planting.